الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. ثم أما بعد، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. This is Yasser Birjas from the Valley Ranch Masjid. Today is the 3rd of Muharram. Muharram is the first month of the lunar calendar, the new year 1432. And Al-Muharram is a sacred month. The translation of this, the meaning of the name, is one of the four sacred months Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran in Surah At-Tawbah. And these months are Dhul-Qa'dah, Dhul-Hijjah, Al-Muharram, and then Rajab. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned these four months in a very special occasion by saying, خَيْرُ الصِّيَامِ بَعْدَ مَنْتِ رَمَضَانِ شَهْرُ اللَّهِ الْمُحَرَّمِ. The best fasting after Ramadan is the fasting of the sacred month. Now the sacred month doesn't mean the four months because they're all sacred in that sense, or is it the actual Al-Muharram? And that is this month that we're talking about and this month that we're in right now, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Now regardless whether they are all the four months or that particular month, this month is the one that is mentioned right now. Since we are in a sacred month, which is Al-Muharram as well, the Prophet ﷺ encouraged that we fast during these blessed days of Shahrullah Al-Muharram. Particularly the 10th of Al-Muharram, we know it as Ashura. Ashura, when the Prophet ﷺ migrated from Mecca to Medina, he found that the Jewish tribes of Medina, they were fasting that day, observing fast of that day. And when he asked them about the reason behind their fasting, observation of fast of that day, they said that is the day when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved Musa from Fir'aun. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he replied that I have more right in Musa than you. So he fasted that day and he ordered the Muslim community to fast that day. And then he said to them, then أَحْيَانِ اللَّهُ إِلَىٰ قَابِلِ. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills that I live until the next year, I shall fast the 9th and the 10th. So we'll fast Tasu'a and Ashura, the 9th of Al-Muharram and the 10th of Al-Muharram. The 9th and the 10th of the Muharram for this year, inshallah ta'ala, will be the 15th and the 16th of December. So it's going to be Wednesday and Thursday, inshallah tabaraka wa ta'ala. You make sure that you fast these days, bi'idhnillahi azza wa jal. Of course, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave life to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the companions for the following years as well. But during the next year, Allah azza wa jal revealed the obligation of the fast of the month of Ramadan. So therefore, Ramadan was the obligation and Ashura became an optional fasting. And alhamdulillah, now that we live in a beautiful season, it's cold weather, it's the winter, the day is very short, you will have a plenty inshallah of time during the night. The weather is very pleasant and nice. You will not find it hard to fast Wednesday and Thursday, Tasua and Ashura. My advice for you, my brothers and sisters, that you try your best to put this in your calendar, inshallah azza wa jal, and you make sure to fast on Wednesday and fast on Thursday. Count these as the blessed days of Al-Muharram, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you for your fasting. I want you also to know that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that fasting one day for the sake of Allah azza wa jal will bring you away from Jahannam, will take you away from Jahannam a distance of 70 years. So if you have the opportunity for fasting 2 days, you'll make it inshallah ta'ala for this coming week. Bi'idhnillahi azza wa jal. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.